Hi everyone, welcome to the next session of Geotechnical Engineering 2. Up to now we discussed about the what is meant by earth pressure and what are the various type of earth pressure theories. We have discussed about the active earth pressure, we have discussed about the passive earth pressure, the Rankine's earth pressure theory in cohesionless soil as well as in cohesive soil, Coulomb's earth pressure theory, Kalman's graphical method. These are the different type of topics we discussed in our previous sessions. Today we are going to solving some problems based on those concepts. They never ask the analysis or procedure for the all type of this geotechnical engineering too. Compulsory they will ask the questions. That means problems based on the concept what you are discussed in the all chapters. Okay, this is the problem. First I am reading the problem. The problem is: a retaining wall 6 meter height retains dry sand with an angle of internal friction of 30 degrees and unit weight of 16.2 kN per meter cube. Determine the earth pressure at rest condition. If the water table rises to the top of the wall, determine the increase in the thrust on the wall. Assume that submerged unit weight of sand as 10 kN per meter cube. This is the question they are given in the problem. Okay, first based on the given parameters, I will write the given data. But given data I am writing here. Okay, the first one is they are giving it as the retaining wall height of retaining wall. They are given in the problem as 6 meters. Suppose this is your ground level. Okay, this is your ground level or ground surface. From ground surface to the height of the retaining wall is, they are given in the problem, it as 6 meters. They are given in the problem as 6 meters. As well as they are given in the problem angle of internal friction of the soil mass phi equal to 30 degrees. Angle of interfriction of the soil mass phi equal to 30 degrees. And unit weight of the soil gamma or gamma d. Unit weight of the soil mass gamma equal to 16.2 kN per meter cube. Okay, when the wall is at rest condition, for that we have to calculate the lateral earth pressure as well as, suppose if water table is present in this ground surface, what it will happen to the again earth pressure, and the difference between how much amount of lateral earth pressure is acting on the wall when water is present and water is not present, that we have to calculate. Again I am writing here. While you are writing, examination should have to write all your parameters. That means height of the wall. For simplification I am writing this in terms of meters, that equal to height of wall h equal to 6 meters, as well as angle of internal friction phi equal to 30 degrees, and they are given the problem as unit weight of the soil mass. That unit weight of the soil mass gamma equal to 16.2 kN per meter cube. Unit weight of the soil mass gamma equal to 16.2 kN per meter cube. This is the question they are given in the problem. If you observe here, they consider that the earth pressure at a rest condition. That means the wall either not moving away from the soil, or the wall are not moving towards the soil. When the wall is in at rest condition, that is when the wall is a rigid condition, what is the pressure acting on the wall, that we have to calculate. Already the coefficient of earth pressure at rest we know. Okay, earth pressure is the pressure acting on the wall. The ratio of horizontal earth pressure to the ratio of vertical earth pressure is nothing but we call it as a coefficient of earth pressure. If the wall is moving away from the backfill, then we are calling it as active earth pressure. If the wall is moving towards the backfill, then we are calling it as the passive earth pressure. Okay, if you consider here, our present condition is at a rest condition. At rest condition. At rest condition, we are having the coefficient of earth pressure. That means the coefficient of earth pressure at rest condition k naught equal to sigma h divided by sigma v. Where k naught is the coefficient of earth pressure at rest condition, sigma h is the horizontal pressure acting on the wall, sigma v is the vertical pressure acting on the wall. Suppose if you see here, this is your retaining wall. For this retaining wall, how much amount of horizontal pressure is acting as well as how much amount of vertical pressure is acting, that we have to calculate. From this, the horizontal earth pressure sigma h equal to k naught into sigma v, where sigma h is the horizontal earth pressure. For this horizontal earth pressure, we are naming it as p naught. That means horizontal earth pressure at rest condition p naught equal to k naught into sigma v. Okay, that means k naught into vertical pressure, where sigma v is nothing but the vertical pressure at which depth we are calculating that height with respect to the unit weight of the soil mass, that we have to substitute. Suppose if you want to calculate this earth pressure at this point, the height of the wall h equal to 6 meters and the unit weight of the soil mass gamma equal to 16.2 kilonewton per meter cube. If you want to calculate the vertical pressure at this point, sigma v equal to gamma into h. That is the calculation we have to calculate for the earth pressure at the rest condition. From this, sigma v equal to k naught into horizontal earth pressure, you can write either it as a sigma h or p naught. And finally, we have to represent with respect to the p naught. That means earth pressure at rest condition is p naught. As sigma h is the horizontal earth pressure at a rest condition, k naught into sigma v, where sigma equal to gamma into h, where sigma equal to gamma into h. K naught is the coefficient of the earth pressure. The coefficient of earth pressure according to Jarty's formula already we know. That coefficient k naught value, it will be k naught equal to 1 minus sin phi. Coefficient of earth pressure is the value of k naught equal to 1 minus sin phi. That coefficient of earth pressure, first we have to calculate before calculating the horizontal earth pressure acting on the wall. That k naught equal to 1 minus sin phi. 1 minus sin phi is nothing but 1 minus sin phi is the angle of internal friction. That the angle of internal friction they are given in the problem as 30 degrees. Hence we have to substitute in terms of phi as angle of internal friction as sin 30 degrees. That means k naught equal to 1 minus sin 30 degrees. That is 1 minus sin 30 is nothing but 1 by 2. Sin 30 is 1 by 2. That is nothing but 0.5. Suppose 1 minus 0.5 equal to, we are having the value of coefficient of earth pressure at rest condition. We are having this value as 0.50. This is the coefficient of earth pressure at a rest condition. From this, we have to calculate the coefficient of earth pressure at a rest condition. That is nothing but P naught equal to, where K naught is the coefficient of earth pressure. That coefficient of earth pressure equal to 0.50 into gamma is the unit weight of the soil. That unit weight of the soil we are having 16.2 into, where h is the height of the wall. The height of the wall we have taken in this problem as 6 meters. That is the horizontal pressure at a height of 6 meters, p naught equal to k naught into gamma into h. That is nothing but 0.5 into 16.2 into 6. Okay, 48.6 kilonewton per meter. Okay, 48.6 kilonewton, 48.6 kilonewton per meter square. If you observe here, where 6.2 is in term units of kilonewton per meter cube and height of wall is in meter. Okay, kilonewton per meter cube into meter divided by meter cube. Meter cube 1 meter cancel, you get the value as P naught equal to 48.6 kilonewton per meter square. Next, we have to calculate the total horizontal pressure acting on the wall. Suppose if you observe here, we consider the horizontal pressure acting on the base of the wall at this particular height. If you observe here from this point, from this point to the horizontal pressure acting at base of the wall is nothing but we are having the 48.6. If you observe here, while going to the bottom of the soil mass, from top of the wall to the bottom of the wall, we are going to the downside, the lateral earth pressure, it will increase while increasing the depth of the soil mass. This is the horizontal pressure acting at this point. Next, we have to calculate the total horizontal pressure acting on the wall. The total horizontal pressure is nothing but half into base into height of the wall. That we will calculate in a step. Okay. The total earth pressure. Okay, I am writing here. The total earth pressure. The total earth pressure at rest condition. The total earth pressure at rest condition. The total earth pressure at rest condition. The total earth pressure at rest condition that we have to calculate. If you see here, this is your retaining wall. This is your ground surface. From this ground surface to this bottom of the wall, the earth pressure, the earth pressure acting on the wall is 48.6, and this is the height of the wall H, and this is the ground surface. For this we have to calculate the total horizontal earth pressure. The total horizontal earth pressure is nothing but half into base into height. Okay, I am writing the total horizontal earth pressure at rest condition. The total earth pressure at rest condition P naught equal to half into this base value into, that means half into base value, 48.6 into height of the wall. Height of the wall, they are given in the problem as 6 meters. Half into earth pressure acting at height of the wall into height of the wall as 6 meters. Okay. The total horizontal earth pressure at rest condition P naught equal to 2 into 2 threes. Okay. 48.6 into 3. We are having 145.80. Again, if you see here kilonewton per meter square. Here, meter. Again, meter square, we are having the total horizontal earth pressure acting on the wall equal to 145.80 into kilonewton per meter. This is the problem how we are calculating based on the earth pressure at rest condition acting on the wall. Okay, up to now this is the problem. If you directly know the formula, you can directly substitute the values. That means the horizontal earth pressure at rest condition, the total horizontal earth pressure at rest condition, P naught equal to half into K naught into gamma H square. PA equal to half into K into gamma H square. PP equal to half into KP into gamma H square. If you know the formula, directly you can substitute the value. Okay, otherwise I am writing here one more formula, direct formula, that P naught equal to half into K naught into gamma into H square. This is the formula directly we can write. That is nothing but half into K naught value we are having 0.50 into gamma is the unit weight of the soil mass. That unit weight of the soil mass given in the problem as 16.2 into, where H is the height of the wall. That height of the wall we are having 6 square. That is nothing but 0.5 into, sorry, 0.5 × 0.5 × 16.2 × 36. Okay, we are having 145.80 kilonewton per meter. If you know the formula, directly you can use this formula and you can calculate the horizontal earth pressure at rest condition. Okay, up to now this is the one problem. If you observe in our present problem, they also ask you to calculate the, determine the increase in the thrust on the wall. Determine the increase in the thrust on the wall. Assume submerged unit weight of sand as 10 kilonewton per meter cube. Okay, I will explain this. Okay, what they are saying in second problem is, the same retaining wall they are given in the problem. Okay, in second condition, suppose if you observe here, this is your ground surface. From this ground surface to, now the water table is present here, and this is the height of the wall, h 6 meters. And due to presence of this water table at ground surface, the unit weight of the soil mass, it will may change. That means the unit weight, when the water present in the above the soil surface, then we are calling it as submerged unit weight. The submerged unit weight, directly they are given in the problem as 10 kilonewton per meter cube. If they are not given in the problem, then you have to calculate gamma sag, then you have to subtract with gamma w, then you will get the submerged unit weight of the soil mass here. But directly they are given the submerged unit weight of the soil mass, gamma sub equal to 10 kilonewton per meter cube. Gamma submerged equal to 10 kilonewton per meter cube, as well as angle of internal friction phi equal to 30 degrees. For this, they are asked to calculate the horizontal earth pressure, the total horizontal earth pressure. Here directly I am writing the total horizontal earth pressure by using the formula. Okay, at rest condition, again I am writing here, at rest condition, the total horizontal earth pressure, the total horizontal earth pressure due to submerged condition. That submerged condition is nothing but, first again we have to calculate coefficient of earth pressure at rest condition equal to horizontal earth pressure to the vertical earth pressure. From that we have to calculate the sigma h. After calculation of sigma h, we have to calculate the total earth pressure. The total earth pressure is nothing but half into base into height. Instead of that, directly I am writing the total horizontal pressure acting on the wall. The total horizontal pressure directly acting on the wall, P naught equal to half into K naught into, if you observe here, they are given in the problem as gamma submerged. That means if the water table is present above the water table, and here the soil is in the submerged condition, hence we have to substitute here as gamma sub w, gamma sub. That means the total horizontal pressure P naught equal to half into K naught into gamma sub into h square, where h is the height of the wall. That is nothing but P naught equal to half into K naught, our value already we have calculated, that is 1 minus sin 5. That is nothing but we are having value of 0.50 into gamma submerged is the submerged unit weight of the soil. They are given in the problem, it has 10 kilonewton per meter cube, and the h is the height of the wall. That height of the wall we are having 6 and 6 square. Okay, height of the wall is equal to 6 square. The total horizontal pressure due to submerged condition, P naught equal to 0.5 × 0.5 ×, okay, 10 × 36. Okay, we are having 90 kilonewton per meter. And again, if you see here, the water table is present here, due to presence of water table, the soil itself will create pressure on the wall, as well as pore water pressure also will create pressure on the wall. Then we have to also calculate the pore water pressure acting on the wall. That pore water pressure is nothing but half into gamma w into h square. Okay, up to now this is the condition, you know. But again, if you see here, the soil is having the water table at ground surface. Due to presence of water table at ground surface, soil will create pressure on the wall, and water will create pressure in the soil. Again, due to pore water pressure, the amount of increase in pressure is more. The total horizontal pressure nothing but half into gamma w into h square plus half into gamma w is the unit weight of the soil mass. If they are not mentioned the unit weight of the soil mass in any way, then you can take the unit weight of the soil mass either 9.81 or 10 kilo per meter cube. Okay, I am assuming that the unit weight of the soil mass as unit weight of the water as 9.81 kilonewton per meter cube, and h square is the height of the wall. That height of the wall we are having 36. Here 90 kilonewton per meter plus, as well as we are having the pore water pressure. That is nothing but 0.5 into 9.81 into 36. Okay, we are having 176.58 kN per meter. Okay, next, the horizontal earth pressure due to combination of both the soil mass and pore water pressure, the total horizontal pressure is 176.58 plus 90. Okay, we are having 266.58 kilonewton per meter. Suppose if you want to draw the pressure diagram for this earth retaining structure, suppose this is your retaining wall. Okay, this is your retaining wall. For this retaining wall, the horizontal pressure at base of the horizontal pressure at base of the wall is nothing but here, that is nothing but k naught into gamma sub into h, as well as the pore water pressure also will create pressure on the wall. Due to pore water pressure, the pressure creating on the wall is nothing but gamma w into h. For pore water pressure, we won't substitute the coefficient of earth pressure. Okay, this is the formula. If you observe here, they asked in the problem as assume the submerged unit weight. What they are asked to do? If the water table rises to the top of the wall, determine the increase in thrust on the wall. Because of pore water pressure and water table present in the soil, the horizontal earth pressure is increased. How much it is increased, that we have to calculate. Okay? That is nothing but, if you neglect the total horizontal earth pressure minus the earth pressure and the dry condition. Okay, I am directly writing here. Increase in thrust or increase in horizontal earth pressure. Increase in thrust. Thrust is nothing but the total horizontal force acting on the wall. Increase in thrust due to water table. Increase in thrust due to water table. But water table is increase in thrust due to water table is nothing but P naught equal to 266.58 minus 145.80. Okay, 266.58 minus 145.80. Okay, the increase in pressure we are having 120.78 kilonewton per meter. This is the amount of horizontal pressure increasing on the wall due to presence of water table on the wall. This is up to now, this is the procedure for calculation of total earth pressure. The same problem is repeating for all type of problems. Based on the type of the condition, we have to calculate the coefficient of earth pressure Next, we have to calculate the how much horizontal pressure is acting on the wall, as well as how much total thrust is acting on the wall, that we have to calculate. Okay, up to now this is the problem. Okay, next we will solve the one more problem. Okay, we will solve the one more problem. Here this problem is, next again I am reading the problem. The problem is, what are the limiting, the second problem we are having here. Okay, the second problem is, what are the limiting values of the lateral earth pressure at a depth of 3 meters in a uniform sand filled with a unit weight of 20 kN per meter cube and a friction angle of 35 degrees. The ground surface is level. If a retaining wall with a vertical back face is interposed, determine the total active thrust and the total passive resistance which will act on the wall. Nothing but they are asked about to calculate, they are given on retaining wall, height of the wall, as well as unit weight of the soil mass, as well as angle of interfriction they are given. For this we have to calculate the total active earth pressure, total passive earth pressure. Rightly I can say that the total active earth pressure PA equal to half into KA into gamma H square. The total passive resistance PP equal to half into KP into gamma H square. Before calculating this, first we have to calculate the coefficient of active earth pressure, coefficient of passive earth pressure. Next we have to see whether the unit weight directly given in the problem or not. After our final step, we can make calculate. Okay, first I will show in the diagram. If you see here, this is your retaining wall. The retaining wall, they are given the height of the retaining wall as h equal to 3 meters. The height of the retaining wall given in the problem as h equal to 3 meters, as well as they are given the unit weight of the soil mass gamma equal to, the unit weight of the soil mass gamma equal to 20 kilonewton per meter cube, and the friction angle of the soil mass phi equal to, friction angle of the soil mass phi equal to 35 degrees. The ground surface is level, that means the ground surface is level. Then they are asking to calculate the, when the wall moves away from the backfill, when the wall moves towards the backfill. Suppose this is your backfill. For this backfill, when the wall moves away from the backfill towards the backfill, what it will happen, that we have to calculate. Okay, again I am writing here the given parameters. Okay, given. Again, while writing, you should have to write all the names. Height of the wall, h equal to, they are given in the problem as 6 meters. Next, they are given the unit weight of the soil mass, gamma equal to 20 kilonewton per meter cube. Gamma equal to 20 kilonewton per meter cube. Next, angle of internal friction, phi equal to 35 degrees. Okay, next we have to calculate the KA value, as well as we have to calculate the KP value. After that we have to calculate the PA comma PP. Okay, PA comma PP, that means horizontal earth pressure at rest condition, horizontal earth pressure in active condition, horizontal earth pressure in passive condition, we have to calculate. Before calculating that, we will calculate the coefficient of the earth pressures. That coefficient of earth pressures, KA, we are having the formula for active earth pressure. When the wall moves away from the backfill, we are having the coefficient of earth pressure in active condition, that is nothing but KA equal to 1 minus sin 5 divided by 1 plus sin 5. This is the coefficient of active earth pressure. The ratio of horizontal earth pressure to vertical earth pressure when the wall moves away from the backfill. Next, we are having the coefficient of passive earth resistance. That coefficient of passive earth resistance, Kp, equal to 1 plus sin 5 divided by 1 minus sin 5. Okay, the Kp is always reciprocal to the Ka value. Okay, first we will calculate the Ka value. Ka equal to 1 minus sin 5, we are having the value of 1 minus sin
5, sin 5 are given the problem as sin 35 degrees, 1 minus sin 5 35 degrees divided by 1 plus sin 35 degrees. As well as coefficient of width present KP, we are having the formula 1 plus sin 35 degrees divided by 1 minus sin 35 degrees. Okay, from this KA equal to 1 minus sin 35. 1 minus sin 35 divided by 1 plus sin 35. Okay, I am getting this KA value as 0.635. Coefficient of H pressure KA as 0.635. If you want to calculate the KP value, directly KP equal to 1 by KA. 1 by 0.635, if you substitute, you will get the KP value. Otherwise, you can use this formula also. We can get the coefficient of passive at the pressure, that KP equal to 1 plus sin 35 divided by 1 minus sin 35. Okay, I am getting this value as 2.34 or 1 divided by 0.635. Okay, 1 plus, sorry, KP equal to 1 by KA 0.635. Okay, you don't multiply this, calculate this once, maybe that mistake happened. KP equal to 1 plus sin 35 by 1 minus sin 35. 1 plus sin 35 divided by 1 minus sin 35. Okay, again we will calculate this. I think KA we are getting something wrong value. 1 minus sin 35 divided by 1 plus sin 35. Okay, sorry, we are getting this coefficient of width pressure KA as 0.27. Next we will calculate the KP value. 1 plus sin 35 by sin 35, 3.69. Okay, KP equal to 3.69. Okay, now if you calculate 1 divided by 3.6, 3.7. Okay, this is the formula. Okay, here I did a mistake in the calculation, where KA equal to 1 minus sin 35 divided by 1 plus sin 35. So you can use bracket, then only you will get the correct answer. Otherwise, you will get the wrong answer. Otherwise, you can directly already have proven that the formula is correct. That is nothing but KP equal to 1 divided by KA. If you calculate the KA value, KP value you can get. If you calculate the KP value, KA value you can get. Okay, from this is the coefficient of active earth pressure and the coefficient of passive earth pressure. KA equal to 0.27. Next, KP value equal to 3.69. Okay, 3.69. This is the formulas for the coefficient of earth pressure. Next, we will calculate the active earth pressure and the passive earth pressure. And if you see here, this is your retaining wall, and from this retaining wall, this is the ground surface level condition. For this, the horizontal pressure is linearly varying from top of the wall to the bottom of the wall. This is the horizontal pressure acting on the wall. The horizontal pressure acting on the wall, it will be like this. This is the total height of the wall. This is the horizontal earth pressure PA acting on the wall. That PA is nothing but KA into gamma into H. KA into gamma into H. Okay, again for this problem, I am repeating again from the basic. Next time onwards, I will directly calculate the horizontal earth pressure, total horizontal earth pressure by using the formula. If you observe here, if they want to calculate the total active thrust or total passive thrust, or total horizontal pressure or total passive pressure, then only you should have to use the PA equal to half into K into gamma H square, or PP equal to half into KP into gamma H square. If they ask just to calculate the active pressure or active earth pressure, then you should have to use this formula only, PA equal to K into gamma H. If suppose they are asking active thrust or total pressure, then you have to use this the area of the pressure diagram. If they are asking active pressure only, then you have to use only K into gamma H. Okay? At rest condition, at the active condition, first I am calculating the active condition, active case or active pressure. Okay, for active pressure, the coefficient of earth pressure, Ka equal to, the coefficient of earth pressure in active condition, Ka equal to nothing but, again we are having ratio of horizontal earth pressure to the vertical earth pressure, from vertical effective pressure. From this sigma h we have to calculate. Again sigma h equal to Ka into sigma into V. Again the horizontal earth pressure, sigma h equal to Ka into, where sigma V is nothing but the unit weight of the soil mass with respect to the depth height of the wall, that is nothing but gamma into H. If you observe here, when I represented sigma H, this is the horizontal pressure. The total horizontal pressure, if you want to calculate, then you have to calculate, you have to find out for the total area of the pressure diagram. Okay, sigma H equal to Ka into gamma H. Again, sigma H, I can write it as active pressure, the horizontal pressure acting on the wall, Ta equal to Ka into gamma H. Ka value already we have calculated, that is 1 minus sin phi by 1 plus sin phi, we are having 0.27. okay, Ka value we are having 0.27, and gamma is the unit weight of the cell. I think unit weight of the cell they are given in the problem as 20 kilonewton per meter cube, and H is the height of the wall. Height of the wall they are given in the problem as 3 meters. If you observe here, Pa equal to 0.27 into 20 into 3. We are having 16.20. Here kilonewton per meter cube per meter. That means kilonewton per meter square. Kilonewton per meter square. That means if you observe here the pressure acting on the wall, 16.20 kilonewton per meter. This is the value, 16.20 kilonewton per meter square acting at a height of 3 meters. Next, I am calculating the total active pressure acting on the wall, or the total horizontal pressure acting on the wall. Okay, I am writing here the total horizontal active earth pressure, the total horizontal active earth pressure, the total horizontal active earth pressure, again nothing but Pa equal to the total horizontal pressure for the entire this pressure diagram equal to area of the pressure diagram. Area of the pressure diagram is nothing but half into base into height of the wall. Area of the triangle or area of the pressure triangle, that is nothing but half into base value we are having Ka into gamma into H. That value we are having 16.20, half into base into height, that is nothing but height of the wall we are having H as 3 meters. Otherwise I am writing here area of the pressure diagram, that is nothing but half into Ka into gamma into H into H, H into H. This is the total horizontal pressure acting on the wall. Up to now this is the horizontal pressure. If you substitute with to H, this is the horizontal pressure at base of the wall. If you substitute the half into base of the height wall, we can get the total horizontal pressure. Okay, that total horizontal pressure, how much it is, now we calculate that Pa equal to 0.5 into 15.20 into 3. Okay. 24. If you see here, 16.20 is kilon per meter square. Again here meter we are having. The horizontal pressure is nothing but we are having 24.30 kilonewton per meter. 24.30 kilonewton meter. From this area of the pressure diagram, the entire wall, the total pressure acting on the wall at a centroidal distance, it will be 24.30 kilonewton per meter square. Kilonewton per meter. Next, we will calculate the passive condition, how much amount of earth pressure is resisting. Okay, next I am writing this passive earth pressure or passive resistance. Passive earth pressure. Okay, here directly I am writing the formula. That formula equal to nothing but the total horizontal, the total passive earth resistance, the total passive earth resistance, the total passive earth pressure resistance Pp equal to half into Kp into gamma into h square. The total passive earth pressure resistance Pp equal to half into Kp into gamma into h square, where Pp equal to half into Kp is the coefficient of earth pressure in passive condition. You can directly use the formula here or individually we can calculate. That is 1 minus sin 1 plus sin 35 divided by 1 minus sin 35. That we are getting around 3.67 or something. Okay, 3.69. We are getting this Kp value as 3.69. And the height of the wall they are given in the problem as 3 meters square. That is nothing but 3 square. The passive earth pressure resistance Pp equal to half into Kp into gamma into h square. Sorry, I have forgotten to return the gamma value. That gamma value is the unit weight of the soil mass that given the problem as 20 kilonewton per meter cube. Nothing but 0.5 into 3.69 into 9 into 20. Okay, I am getting this passive earth resistance as 332.10 kilonewton per meter. 332.10 kilonewton per meter. This is the how the passive earth resistance will resist the pressure acting on the soil mass. Okay, again you can directly write or you can use the formula. That is nothing but the ratio of horizontal earth pressure to the vertical earth pressure. From this horizontal earth pressure, sigma h equal to Kp into sigma v. Kp is 1 plus sin 5 by 1 minus sin 5. Sigma v equal to gamma into h. By substituting the above formula also, we can calculate the passive earth pressure. This is the, up to now, this is the problem for the our second problem. We have calculated the active earth pressure. We have calculated the passive earth pressure. Next, we will solve the one more problem. Okay, this is the problem. Okay, if you observe here, first I will read the problem. Next, we will write the given data, then next we will calculate the earth pressure of the soil mass. If you observe here, the problem is, that is number problem number 3. The problem number 3 is a smooth backed vertical wall is 6.3 meters height and retains a soil with a bulk unit weight of 18 kilonewton per meter cube. And angle of internal friction phi equal to 18 degrees. The top of the soil is level with the top of the wall. The top of the soil is level with the top of the wall. And it is horizontal. If the soil surface carries a uniformly distributed load of 4.5 kN per meter square, determine the total active thrust. Determine the total active thrust on the wall. For linear meter, sorry, per meter length of the wall, per meter length of the shear meter length of the wall and its point of application. Per meter length of the wall and its point of application. Okay, this is the problem they are given in the question. Okay, first based on the condition given in the problem, we will write the diagram. After we will try to solve the problem. Again, if you see here, a smooth backed vertical wall is 6.3 meter high. What they are giving means, if you observe here, they are given in the problem as a height of the wall as 6.3 meter. Suppose this is your ground surface. From this ground surface to we are having height of the wall as 6.30 meters. Retains a soil with a bulk unit weight of 18 kilonewton per meter cube. That unit weight of the soil mass gamma they are given. And unit weight of the soil mass gamma equal to 18 kilonewton per meter cube. 18 kilonewton per meter cube. And the angle of intersection of the soil mass phi equal to 18 degrees. Angle of intersection of the soil mass phi equal to 18 degrees. The top of the soil with the top of the wall and it is horizontal. This is the ground surface, it is horizontal. If the soil surface carries a uniformly distributed load of 4.5 kilonewton per meter square, that means what they are giving means, suppose this is your soil mass and this is your backfill. For this backfill, there is a uniformly distributed load of 4.5 kilonewton per meter square. This is the uniformly distributed load acting on the backfill. That value is nothing but 4.5 kilonewton per meter square, 4.5 kilonewton per meter square. For this condition, we have to calculate the total horizontal earth pressure. If you know the formula directly, you can calculate. But while writing your examination, we have to solve by step procedure. Okay. First, we will write the given data. Okay. I will write the given data. And the given data equal to where h is the height of the wall. At height of the wall we are having 6.30 meters and unit weight of the soil mass gamma equal to 18 kilonewton per meter cube. Unit weight of the soil mass gamma equal to 18 kilonewton per meter cube and angle of intersection of the soil mass phi equal to 18 degrees. Next, if you observe here, they can ask you to calculate the total active thrust. That means PA we have to calculate. Okay. Before calculating PA, the coefficient of active earth pressure KA, that we have to calculate. Before writing the formula, we will calculate the KA value, coefficient of earth pressure. That coefficient of earth pressure KA equal to nothing but we are having the formula 1 minus sin 18 degrees divided by 1 plus sin 18 degrees. 1 minus sin 18 degrees divided by 1 plus sin 18 degrees. Individually I am calculating 1 minus sin 18 degrees. Okay. Nothing but we are having 0.69. 1 minus sin.1.30. We are having total 0.69 divided by 0.53. 1 minus sine 18 degrees. We are having the value as 0.527. Okay, I am writing this as 0.53. Coefficient of earth pressure KA value, we are having this value as 0.53. Again, if you observe here, they are given the problem directly. I can write the formula. Next, I will explain the procedure. Suppose if you see here, this is your retaining wall. for this rectangle, this is the horizontal ground surface. From due to this horizontal ground surface, they are given in the uniformly distributed load. But the uniformly distributed load, they are given in the problem, it has 4.50 kilonewton per meter square. And if you see here, first due to presence of uniformly distributed load, the pressure itself will create, and the pressure will be like this only. Due to this uniformly distributed load, the pressure it will create on the wall will be in rectangular portion only. Next, the pressure, the second procedure due to horizontal due to the soil is same. Okay, the horizontal pressure or the vertical pressure acting on the wall is nothing, it will be like this. Next, we are having the our regular earth pressure due to the soil, that is nothing but it will be like this. If you see here, the vertical pressure due to load acting on the wall, Ka into Q. Sorry, I have forgot to written here. The uniformly distributed load, we are naming it as Ka Q. That Q value is nothing but 4.50 kilonewton per meter square. 4.50 kilonewton per meter square. And if you see here, this is Ka into Q. This Ka into Q is acting due to the soil mass, sorry, due to the uniformly distributed load, that it will create the rectangular pressure up to the bottom of the wall. Again, due to the pressure, what is available here, again, it will be linearly varying from top of the wall to the bottom of the wall. That is nothing but Ka into gamma into H. If suppose, if you want to calculate the total horizontal pressure, that is nothing but area of this rectangular pressure diagram, area of this diagram, that is nothing Ka into Q into H, half into Ka into gamma into H square. Okay, this is the problem already we have seen in our discussion. Okay, I am directly writing the formula. The total horizontal earth pressure acting on the wall when the soil is carries uniformly distributed load. Okay, the total horizontal earth pressure, when the soil carries, when the soil carries uniformly distributed load of 4.50 uniformly distributed load of 4.50 kilonewton per meter square. This is the formula directly I am substituting the total horizontal earth pressure. The total horizontal earth pressure Pa equal to area of this rectangular pressure diagram. Due to uniformly distributed load, the load will create in the bottom of the wall in the rectangular portion. And the linear pressure will be vary from bottom to the top of the wall due to the presence of soil mass. That is nothing but Pa equal to Ka into Q into base of the wall into height of the wall. That is the width into depth, Ka into Q into H. Plus due to horizontal earth pressure, we are having the formula half into base of this pressure acting on the wall into height of the wall. Pa equal to half into Ka into gamma into H square. Otherwise, we can divide it as the total horizontal earth pressure Pa equal to Pa1 plus Pa2. That means the horizontal pressure acting on the wall due to the uniformly distributed load of the soil mass, okay, as well as the horizontal pressure acting on the wall due to the soil mass present in the soil mass. Again, from this we will calculate that Pa equal to Pa1 equal to Ka into Q into H, half into Ka into gamma H square. Pa1 equal to nothing but Ka into Q into H. Ka we are having 0.53, that means 0.53 into Q is the uniformly distributed load acting on the wall. That is nothing but 4.50. 50 kilonewton per meter square into, we are having next height of the wall. Height of the wall they are given in the problem, I think it is 6.30 meters. Okay, the height of the wall as we are having 6.30. Okay, this is TA one value, or nothing but KA into Q into H value. Now this will calculate, that value is nothing but we are having 0.53 into 4.50 into 6.30 equal to 15.025. If you see here, uniform distributed kilonewton per meter square and height of the wall is in meter, that the total pressure PA1 equal to 15.02 kilonewton per meter. 15.02 kilonewton per meter. Next, you will calculate the PA2. That PA2 equal to nothing but half into KA into gamma into H square. That is nothing but half into KA. We are having this value as 0.53 into gamma is nothing but unit weight of the soil mass. That unit weight of the soil mass they are given the problem as 18. Okay, 18 into, okay, where H is the height of the wall. Height of the wall is 6.30 square. Okay, 6.30 square. That is nothing but 0.53 into 18 into 6.3 into 6.3. Okay, I am getting this horizontal earth pressure due to this pressure diagram. That is nothing but 189.32 kilonewton per meter. This total horizontal pressure PA equal to PA1 plus PA2. PA1 is nothing but KA into Q into H, that is due to the uniformly soil carrying load, plus half into KA into gamma H square, that is nothing but due to area of this pressure diagram. From this we will calculate the total horizontal earth pressure. The total horizontal pressure PA equal to, again I am rewriting the same formula, that is nothing but P1 plus P2, where P1 equal to KA into Q into H, plus P2 equal to half into gamma into KA into H square, half into KA into gamma into H square. KA into Q value we calculated as 15.02 kilonewton per meter, 15.02 kilonewton per meter, plus the horizontal earth pressure due to the soil mass we are having 189.32 kilonewton per meter, 189.32 kilonewton per meter. From this we are calculating the total horizontal earth pressure PA equal to 15.02 plus 189.32. We are getting the total horizontal earth pressure due to uniformly distributed load as well as due to the horizontal pressure acting on the wall. It will be 204.34 kilonewton per meter. 204.34 kilonewton per meter. This is the horizontal pressure acting on the wall. Total horizontal pressure acting on the wall. If you observe here, they are asked in the problem, determine the total active thrust per meter length of the wall and its point of application. And its point of application means, that point of application means, suppose this is your ground surface and this is your retaining wall, and for this retaining wall, due to uniformly distributed load, this is the horizontal portion acting on the wall, and this is the pressure diagram. And if you observe here, this is P1, this is P2. Okay, they are asking the point of application of the soil mass. That KA into Q value we know, that KA into Q value at how much height it is acting on the wall. Again, K into gamma H, we know that K into gamma H value, how much half into K into gamma P A equal to K into Q into H plus half into K into gamma H. Okay. This is the if you observe here in this present diagram, how much the PA1 is acting on this rectangular portion, as well as how much distance it is acting on the triangular portion that we have to calculate. That is nothing but point of application of the horizontal earth pressure at a particular point that we have to calculate. Okay, how we are calculating is nothing but this centroidal distance as well as this centroidal distance. Okay, I am writing in next page, that is point of application of horizontal thrust. The point of application of horizontal thrust, we are naming it as Z. That means from horizontal ground surface to at which particular depth the both horizontal pressure is acting on the wall. That is nothing but P1 into H by 2 plus P2 into H by 3 divided by P1 plus P2, nothing but P1 is the horizontal pressure acting on the wall due to the uniformly distributed load. For uniformly distributed load acting on the wall, we are having rectangular portion. For rectangle, the centroidal distance is H by 2. Again, P2 is the horizontal pressure acting on the wall due to the soil mass, and H by 3 is the centroidal distance acting on this for the triangular pressure diagram, where P1 plus P2 is the total horizontal pressure that we have to calculate, that it will give the point of application of the soil mass. The point of application of the soil mass Z equal to P1 already we have calculated. The P1 value, it will be 15.02. Okay, P1 value 15.02. That means 15.02 into, where H is the height of the wall. And height of the wall we are having 6.3 divided by 2, where P2 is the horizontal earth pressure due to the soil mass. That is PA2 equal to 189.32. That value, it will be 189.32 into H by 3 is the height of the wall. That is nothing but 6.3 divided by 3. Divided by total, we are having P1 plus P2. P1 is 15.02 plus P2 is nothing but we are having 189.32. Okay, from this the point of application of the soil mass, Z equal to 15.02 into 6.3 divided by 2 plus 189.32 into 6.3 divided by 2. Okay, 646.2 divided by 10.02 plus 32. Okay, the point of application acting on the wall, it will be the point of application acting on the wall, it will be 3.150 meters. Okay, that means the resultant pressure acting on the wall at a height of 3.150 from the base of the wall. Suppose this is your retaining wall, due to uniformly distributed load of the soil mass as well as due to the horizontal earth pressure acting on the wall due to the soil mass, the resultant pressure will be acting at a height of the wall, it will be 3.150 meters, where z equal to 3.150 meters. This is the point of application of the horizontal pressure, point of application of the horizontal pressure. This is the up to now calculation for the earth pressure when the soil carries a uniformly distributed load. Again, if the soil is water table present, the condition is different. Based on the type of the condition, we have to calculate the active earth pressure and the passive earth pressure. Next, we will try to solve one more problem. Okay, the next problem is, okay, here this is the problem number 4, and this problem also based on the Rankine's earth pressure theory. Okay, the problem I am reading here, the problem is, a vertical wall with a smooth face is 7.2 meters height and retains soil with a uniform surcharge angle of 9 degrees. If the angle of interflection of the soil is 27 degrees, compute the active earth pressure and passive earth resistance assuming gamma equal to 20 kN per meter cube. This is the question they are asked in the problem. Okay, a vertical wall with smooth face is 7.2 meters. This is the retaining wall given in the problem. For this retaining wall, we are having height of the wall as 7.20 meters. And retain soil with a uniform surcharge angle of 9 degrees. Suppose if you observe here, this is your ground surface. From this ground surface, the backfill soil mass retains with a uniform surcharge angle. Surcharge means some preload is acting on the soil mass due to inclination of the soil mass. Preload. The preload is acting on the soil mass at a height of, making an angle of inclination of 9 degrees. If the angle of interflection of the soil mass, phi equal to 27 degrees. That means the angle of interflection also they are given in the soil. What is present here? The presented soil will having angle of interflection phi as phi equal to 27 degrees. Okay. Next, angle of making inclination beta equal to 9 degrees. Compute the active earth pressure and passive earth resistance assuming gamma equal to 20 kN per meter cube. The same condition what you are discussing, the previous condition is same. They are asking to calculate the active earth pressure, passive earth pressure. The only difference is here the coefficient of earth pressure, it will may vary. Why? Because the backfill the horizontal ground surface is making an angle of inclination. When making angle of inclination, the coefficient of earth pressure formula is different. That is nothing but Ki equal to cos beta into cos beta minus, that formula we should have to use. Okay, this is the height of the wall and this is the pressure. Okay, retaining wall height they are given, given soil parameters they are giving, as well as they are given the surcharge angle, that means preload of the soil mass is there, that is making an angle. For that condition, we should have to calculate the active earth pressure and the passive earth resistance. Okay, and if you see here, according to Rankine's theory, the coefficient of earth pressure when the soil mass is having an angle of inclination, or such as making an angle of inclination, then the coefficient of inclination formula we are having Ka and coefficient of inclination value we are having Kp. These formulas they won't ask for derivation. You should have to remember this formula. That is nothing but Ka equal to cos beta into cos beta minus square root of cos square beta minus cos square phi divided by cos beta plus square root of cos square beta minus cos square phi. This is the formula. Coefficient of active earth pressure. Ka equal to cos beta into cos beta minus square root of cos square beta minus cos square phi by cos beta plus square root of cos square beta minus cos square phi. From this we have to substitute the formula. That Ka equal to cos beta value such as angle they are given the problem as 9 degrees. Cos 9 into cos 9 degrees minus square root of cos square 9 degree. Cos square 5 is the angle of intersection value they are given in the problem. 27 degrees divided by cos beta, again the same problem. If you substitute the Ka value by substituting all the parameters, you will get the Ka value. Ka equal to 0.998 into 0.397. We are getting this Ka value as 0.392. Again Kp value is nothing but reciprocal of this value, that is 1 divided by 0.39 2.4 double. Okay, no problem. Okay, if you see here Ka value we have calculated, this Kp value is nothing but the reciprocal of the Ka value. When you are not getting this formula, you can directly reciprocal this value. That value also will be nearer to the above value. That Kp equal to again cos beta into cos beta plus square root of cos square beta minus cos square phi divided by cos beta minus square root of cos square beta minus cos square phi. By substituting this formula, we are getting this Kp value as 2.488. From this formula, we are calculating the Ka value as well as we are calculating the Kp value. After calculating Ka and Kp, we should have to calculate the total horizontal earth pressure Pa and the total passive earth pressure resistance Pp. That Pa is nothing but again half into Ka into gamma into H square. Again Pp value we are having half into Kp into gamma into H square. If you substitute the Ka value, gamma value, H square value, the horizontal pressure acting on the one due to such a thing you will get. And if you substitute the Kp of Kp gamma H square, you will get the passive earth resistance acting on the valve. Okay, the same procedure. That is the total active thrust per meter run of the valve. Directly I have written this formulas here. The total active thrust per meter length of the valve is nothing but Pa equal to half into Ka into gamma into H square. Half into area of the pressure diagram. 20 is the unit weight of the sinus given in the problem. H square is the height of the wall and Ka value coefficient of earth pressure we are having 0.392. Okay, 0.392. If you see here the total active thrust here, it is the force and kilonewton per meter. That means for meter length the total horizontal force is acting. That's why we are mentioning the kilonewton per meter, where meter length it will be acting, where Pa is the total horizontal force. Next, the total passive resistance per meter length of the wall, the total passive resistance per meter length of the wall equal to Pp equal to half into gamma into H square into Kp. Again Pp equal half into gamma is the unit weight of the soil mass, H square is the height of the wall and Kp is the coefficient of passive earth pressure. Again, if you want any doubts here, gamma is the unit weight of the soil mass, that is we are having kilonewton per meter cube. Where H square is the height of the wall, we are having meter square we are having kilonewton per meter. Where here meter represents per 1 meter length of the wall or per meter length of the wall, it's creating a force of 1829.89 kilonewton force. That is the point they are mentioned this for particular total horizontal pressure. Up to now, this is the problem calculation for the total active thrust per meter length of the wall as well as total passive resistance per meter length of the wall. In next class, we will try to solve some more problems based on those concepts we have discussed in the
previous sessions. Thank you.